Well, the U.S. Luge slider search is something that the U.S. Luge team has been doing for about 25 years. And basically, we started it to bring the sport of luge to new athletes. It introduces brand new athletes who have never even seen a luge sled before in their life, let alone beyond one before, to the sport of luge with the hopes of getting them involved in the long term. And we've traveled probably 10,000 miles around the country in those 25 years and introduced the sport of luge to thousands and thousands of athletes. And the program works very well. And the only difference between using this sled today in the summer and in the winter is the wheels. We simply take that wheel bracket off and put a steel runner on it, and you can go down the actual ice track on these very same sleds. Now, the very first thing you want to look for when you get on your sled every time is this front bar right here. You can see how it connects the two red runners together. We call that the front bridge. And of course, there's a rear bridge here too that does the same thing. But you're going to be mostly concerned with the front bridge. Every time you come up to your sled, you want to put your butt right up against that front bridge. You want to be touching that the whole time. And if you do that, when you go to lay down into your position, everything just falls right into place very naturally.
Slider search actually has two parts. Number one, of course, is the on-sled component of it. It's very subjective. The coaches watch the kids and see how their position is, see how their control is, see if they're really enjoying themselves and, you know, do they have a passion for the sport. But the flip side of that is the second part of that is the physical testing that we do with them. So we want kids that are not only naturals and very intuitive on the sled, but we're looking for kids that are in very good physical condition too. So we put them through a small battery of fitness tests to see what their fitness skills are.
It's really important for us to get kids who are still young and have a long time to perfect the ins and outs of the sport. Experience is a huge part of it, and you know, we generally don't peak until, you know, mid to late 20s, if not in the early 30s. So getting the years in early is what's going to make the best athletes. So we look at kids around ages 9 to 13 to try and get them into the program and get them exposed to the sport as soon as possible. The first step we take is screening the kids at the slider search programs, and we basically put wheels on training sleds and teach them the real basics of the sport, how to get down a small hill, maybe work up to going down the ramp and the hill, and sometimes building a little course out of cones to see who picks it up really naturally, and also doing a couple physical tests to see, you know, the agility and kind of the coordination level. And we understand kids are still young at that time, so we don't expect them to be, you know, all-star athletes yet. And that's something that is also important because we want to be able to kind of mold them into luge athletes, not have to break them from their previous sport. But athletic background does help. And then from there, kids are invited to Lake Placid where they get to go on the track for real, on the ice for the first time, and then learn a little bit more about the sport and how it works. Usually we get to stay in the training center, like that's what I did when I first got into the sport. So you get that whole Olympic thing dangled right in front of your face, which is pretty exciting. And then from there, the best kids get pulled into the development program, and that puts you kind of on the track to the Olympic team someday, hopefully.
Aaron Hamlin is the prime example of someone who's just who's gotten really far because of her work ethic. She's obviously a very gifted and talented athlete, but she's got that little bit extra that it's required to be the best. And she's very dedicated, and she loves what she does. And, you know, she comes from a great family, and she's got a lot of support, and she's, you know, she's exactly what you want in an athlete.
When you're going backwards, okay, try to bring the knees apart a little bit more, go maybe a little bit more speed, try to get deeper down into the back here, okay.
My first year as a coach with U.S. Luge in 2000-2001 season, Erin was in her first year out of a slider search. So she had gone through a wheel clinic, and her first full winter up here, she was just another face in the crowd, one of the 20 kids on the development team. And she trained through and just developed very, very quickly and made her way on our junior national team, went through the same sort of steps that any other athlete does in our program.
There have definitely been athletes that have not succeeded the first time in the first clinic they attended, but have come back maybe to another city or the following year and try it out again that have gone on to actually make a team and be successful in the sport. To be honest, it's somewhat difficult for us as coaches to see a kid for just 3 hours to see if they're going to be, you know, gold medalist 15 years from now. So we're not always right. The kids that really come back are the ones that really might have a passion for the sport and might excel because you know they love it and you know they're going to put a lot of effort into it.
I did the slider search, and then I got invited to a screening camp in the summer. And I thought it was really fun, but they obviously didn't think I was good enough, so I didn't make the cuts. But the next year I tried to slider search again, made it to the summer, did good enough to get invited to the winter screening camp, and then I just got invited to the development team.
Well, luge is very much a European sport. It has its roots in Europe. It's relatively new in the US. You know, it's been around for a few decades. It's been an Olympic sport since 1964, but it's not a traditional American sport, of course. So instead of waiting for the athletes to come to the sport of luge, that's what the slider search is all about. We take the sport to them, we bring it to their hometowns. There's only two tracks in the US. There's one in Park City, Utah, and one in Lake Placid. So it's a very facility-driven sport. But that also makes a lot of opportunity in the sport for kids that have some talent in it. If they come here and try out and are successful in the slider search, there's really no telling how far they can go. They could make it up to the national team, make it up to an Olympic team someday. And because it's relatively small in the US, they could be very successful if they're talented and willing to put in the effort that it takes to be successful.
I would highly recommend checking out the slider search. Mainly, it's kind of a maybe not once in a lifetime opportunity, since we're hopefully going to do a few here, but definitely, you know, something cool to try. It's something unique, it's something different. You get to sled every day, which is pretty awesome. It's been a cool experience, and I would love to have more people from this area get into it. There is definitely promise, and I think there's a lot of talent in this area that needs to get out there.